Rebels in Libya claim they've seized Muammar Gaddafi's hometown of Sirte. Under the cover of NATO airstrikes, they're relentlessly pushing back Gaddafi's forces. TEN's Brett Mason is with them.
We're just outside the town of Ajdabiya, and you can see here locals are celebrating on the burnt-out wrecks of Gaddafi tanks. This town has been the front line of this battle for the last few days, and we've seen here now the rebel troops pushing down this highway west towards Tripoli. They have some fierce fighting ahead of them, but despite the odds, remarkably, the rebels won this town. They were surrounded by Gaddafi's forces on three sides, and despite facing heavy artillery like this, they still managed to push through. These scenes of atrocities have now become wild celebrations, almost tourist attractions. It's hard to believe that this country is engulfed with war.
Western airstrikes cleared the way, opening a corridor for rebel fighters to simply drive through. With Gaddafi's forces retreating quickly, the rebels faced little resistance as they advanced, examining the damage and handing out aid. In just 48 hours, they reclaimed Ajdabiya, Brega, Ras Lanuf and Bin Jawad. The battle now is in Sirte, Gaddafi's hometown, where state-run TV is reporting more Western bombings.
These are civilian people, populations that are being terrorized every day.
We do have a lot of intelligence reporting about Gaddafi taking the bodies of people he's killed and putting them at the sites where we've attacked.
Barack Obama will address the American people tomorrow on Libya, but this is an operation no longer under his control.
NATO allies have decided to take on the whole military operation in Libya.
Italy wants to grant Colonel Gaddafi exile in a bid to end the stalemate.
We have things in our toolbox in addition to hammers.
In Benghazi, hundreds rallied in support of the woman dragged away after claiming she was beaten and raped by four of Gaddafi's men.
She's safe, she's free with her family, and the case is criminal.
In the United States, Daniel Sutton, 10 News.